I'm your leader now, kid.
They deserve the respect. They were disrespected. I just want you to own it. I just want you to apologize to these two men for it.
Pierce,
that's it.
Pierce, come on. At this point, you're kind of embarrassing me. I recognize you did what you had to do. Let's move forward. It's water under the bridge. Just make the match official.
I'm not being unreasonable. They got hurt. All I'm asking you to do is look them in the eye, acknowledge that they got hurt, and apologize for it. That's it. Nothing more. That's it.
No. Why would I apologize to you two after everything the referees have done to screw me around here? And you, this has happened under your watch. Everything with Punk, WrestleMania, and Scotland in front of my people. After winning Money in the Bank, saying I would cash in that he screws me over. Under your watch, he's sitting cross-legged like an idiot at that table. Are you grabbing him from behind? Are you interfering in his business? Are you setting referees on him? No, that's just me. You deserve that elbow. You should be down on your hands and knees apologizing to me right now. Everybody that's been chanting Punk's name after watching what he's done to me should be in their hands and knees apologizing. Seth Rollins last week thinking he can skip the line, get his hand on Punk before me. And there's not a chance I would ever accept an apology from CM Punk. I want his head on a spike.
I said a lot of things last night.
I expected better from you, Canada, being part of the Commonwealth. No, Punk's not here, but his family are always with me. Speaking of Punk, here's a fair warning to all you guys in the ring. The violence I inflicted upon Punk, that is exactly what's going to happen to each and every one of you if you get in my way tomorrow. In fact, let's meet my competition. El Idiot. Chad, I just feel bad for you. Mello, you got a bright future, but you are not him. You're looking up at him. L.A. Knight. That's not the word you're going to need tomorrow. It's gonna be no. And you. How the hell did you get across the border anyway? I hope you're uncomfortable and in pain and being fed through a straw. Because I did that to you. I put you there.
I didn't just take your dignity, though, did I? I also took this. Now, this is worth about 50 cents. No real meaning. A fan made it for you, but I know to you, punk, it is absolutely priceless. This bears the name of your wife and your stupid-looking dog, Larry. You wear this when you leave home, so you can take them with you, so you don't feel alone. But you are alone, punk, right now, because of me, and in pain and miserable. And this is going to be a theme for you going forward, because I am going to enter the Money in the Bank ladder match. And you are going to watch alone and in pain and miserable. And I am going to win as you lay there alone and in pain and miserable because of me. I know what it feels like to be alone. I felt alone as everybody chanted your name, as the roster accepted you, as management accepted you, when I told them what kind of person you really were. But I'm not alone anymore, am I? I have your dog. I have your wife. I have your family. In my corner now, and at Money in the Bank, I am going to win that contract. I am going to cash it in that night, and you're going to watch alone and in pain and miserable while I have your family by my side and become the world heavyweight champion in spite of your arse.
Drew, you got some serious issues, dude. Since you can't shut that hole in your face, why don't you do something different tonight? I'm thinking you actually say what you're gonna say, but say it to somebody's face.
I would love to say it to somebody's face, but if you were listening, CM Punk keeps running away from me every single week. But since you've been a man, you're stepping up to me right now. I'm gonna say something positive about you right now, because I know your story. You have a very, very inspirational story. You've worked your arse off for years. You've put a shift in. You paid your dues. You deserve all the success in the world. You just don't deserve to be champion. I mean, my next door neighbor, Dave, has a very inspirational story. Doesn't mean he should be world heavyweight champion. This is a case of the title making the man. The Raw title is in its infant stages. It needs the man to make the title. It needs Drew McIntyre.
I'm your friend. We've traveled the world together. We've had epic booze-ups together. And we have had banger after banger after banger after banger after banger match together. So as your friend, I'm here to tell you the hard truth. A one-armed CM Punk kicked your arse.
I I don't care what they think they know. You know what that man did to me. You know how he affected my career when I was a kid. You know better than anybody.
This obsession, fella, this obsession is taking down your career. You're gonna get it out of your head.
All right, you want to do this in front of the world? This has been a conversation we had backstage. You want to tell the hard truths right now, fella? That's what you want to do. Okay, before you were injured, it was banger after banger after banger. But since you've returned, it looks to me like it's been burger after burger after burger.
I'll tell you what, man, since I've been off, I've been watching it, and you're getting really good at those one-liners, fella. I'll tell you, I'll give you that.
He's a former world champion.
What happened last night was complete and utter BS.
Five minutes and 46 seconds. That's how long my moment lasted. But some of you find that funny. It was about 5 minutes longer than most of you last in bed, so shut it.
I would love to get to that ring right now and beat your arse, but Punk, don't you remember what happened last time we were in the ring together? I stomped that stupid little arm of yours because you deserved it, and I told you I prayed for this, and it happened.
Hey, 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 are you a Scottish psychopath in a kilt? Are you an internet troll in a skirt? Let's find out.
This is 2024, you want to get canceled for talk like that? No, no, tonight's perfect. I couldn't have prayed for this. You're in the ring injured, Punk. We're less than 2 weeks to Mania, we're in Chicago. Drew McIntyre is in the world title match. This is divine intervention. That's what this is.
Wrestling gods.
Oh man, I just realized I'm wearing this shirt. What bad manners. You know, on the back it says, number one in the checklist, injure CM Punk.
Drew McIntyre, I ain't never had to put another man's name on a t-shirt to sell it.
Well, we got another shirt. Two-shirt gimmick.
Struggled to get out of that thing with my bicep, something you've probably never had an issue with. You want to know the most ironic thing about you, Punk? The straight edge thing.
What the?
You never drink, you never do drugs, yet you spend all your time in rehab. We did it.
I want to take a moment to say thank you. You don't achieve success alone. And everyone in this arena, everyone across the world, thank you for putting those hands together and for praying harder than you've ever prayed in your entire life. Because of you, this happened. Drew McIntyre, Seth Rollins for the world title at WrestleMania. I gotta be honest, I feel like absolute hell. I am more jet lagged than man right now. I was the first man in that chamber, the last man standing, and I got hurt in there. I got my eardrum blown out. I was struck in the side of the head. My eardrum burst, and I had a bit of an incident after the show. I was talking with the doctor, and he looked at me and told me, Drew, you're hurt. There's a chance you might not make WrestleMania. And I looked at him and said, who do you think I am, CM Punk? Nothing's gonna stop me making Mania. I think I speak on behalf of everybody when I say,
what the hell? I laid you both up perfectly for WrestleMania, and you're potentially gonna screw it all up. Seth, you're the only other person that hates Punk as much as me. You knew how bad he would be for this place, and I took him out. We were supposed to be in this ring, you and I, tonight, talking about our main event match for the world title at WrestleMania. Oh, you like that? I even had the t-shirt commissioned for us. Your extra smile's in the back. Why did you have to get inside his head? Why, Cody? Don't listen to him. You've got to finish the story. You've been talking about it for 2 years now. Think about last year's WrestleMania. Think about all the work you've done this year, on TV, off TV, the media events. You've earned this moment. Don't let me down. Don't let your family down. Don't let all these people down and all the people across the world. I don't want to go here because everybody else does. And I was close with the man. I was his champion in Florida Championship Wrestling. But don't let your dad down.
Hey, Drew. Look, you ain't got to be a prick, all right? And look, what in the world makes you think if he doesn't accept my challenge for WrestleMania, it's going to be you and me? Because we've done this dance twice, and if I remember correctly, you lost.
We both know there was outside reasons why I lost those matches. But is this a case of the pot calling the kettle black? Didn't you lose to him 3 times? You know, I've said some terrible things about you since you returned to WWE. And I meant them. You were a terrible person to me in the past. I think you're a poison to the locker room, but I'm listening to you now, and I can relate to everything you're saying. I've had my dreams taken away from me as well. I was fired from this place, and when I was listening to you talk about your buddy Chad, I can relate to that as well. I don't know, you know, what I believe in. I've went through some changes recently myself. I've never been much of a spiritual person. But I want you to know this. I prayed for this and it happened. When I got into that rumble, I targeted you. I violently assaulted you. I could not let you win that thing. Our champion, he's went down. He's taken the title as far as he could till his body broke. He's done a great job. Who's gonna take it to the next level? I couldn't let it be you. And you eliminated me. And I couldn't sleep that night and I was so angry with myself. Then I heard the news the next day. And I slept like a baby last night. This ain't about anybody else right now. This is about you and me. And since you're following my footsteps, I'm gonna give you some advice. Just be yourself, man. You don't have to wear the suits all the time. You're not running for office. You don't have to use all the big words like a thesaurus with your word of the day toilet paper. And the biggest one of all, just don't smile all the time. You got that big dumb smile. And I can say that because I did it too. I felt like even when I was angry, frustrated, sad, I had to be that beacon of light for the roster. I had to be that leader. I had to put that big dumb smile in my face. Wipe it off, mate. be the real Cody, and if anybody has an issue with the real Cody, they can step up to you and you drop them in their arse.
Since we're talking about stepping up, I assure you, Drew, this is not an act. I smile when I come out here because this is what I love. I appreciate the opportunities I've got because I made them for myself. You're right, we are very similar, similar career paths, but the difference right now is I am thankful, I am grateful, I cherish, I relish my second chance, and you are just standing here complaining about yours.
So this is the real Cody, yeah? Or are you a wolf in politician's clothing? If this is the real Cody, why the hell would you bring Jey Uso to Raw, knowing the trouble it would cause? Is that a case of friends close, enemies closer, huh? What about endorsing CM Punk? You were there back in the day. You know what he's like. You were there with him recently. You know exactly what he's like. Is that to make you happy, or is it to make everybody else happy? I don't like the fact you're a kiss arse at times, but I do like you. And I wish this conversation wasn't happening right now. If Damian Priest wasn't an idiot and cashed in that briefcase when he did, I'd be world champion. We wouldn't be talking right now, but we are. So, you're standing in my way. And like Punk learned last week, if you step in my way, you'll get eaten alive. I'm operating at a different level right now. And when I'm feeling like this, when I'm 100% me, I'm not what's best for business. I am this damn business. And at WrestleMania, the story belongs to Drew McIntyre. The floor is mine. I guess first of all, I want to say congratulations. We're going on just over a month now, and you're still here. See, some of the guys and I have got a bet going in the back that you're going to crash and burn, you're going to self-destruct, and you're costing a lot of people a lot of money the longer you stick around.
That's good.
I guess my big bad words have offended you, they've upset you. Maybe you and Seth have more in common than you actually realize. I don't care what you said outside the company. That's irrelevant. You wanted some headlines. You're bitter. You want some attention because you weren't getting enough. I get it. What I care about is what you do to me personally. And I'm one of the few people on this roster still that traveled the world with you for years. I know the real CM Punk. I've seen what you're truly like, and I've had so many things happen to me caused by you. I could go on for all night, actually. We've only got a three-hour show, so maybe I'll go with the first thing that comes to my head. Remember, you were champion. And you used to refer to yourself as the leader. You would actually walk in the locker room and say, as the locker room leader, because the leader has to announce he's the bloody leader. Back then, I actually needed a leader. I needed somebody to help me out. I was in a real dark place. Right now, I'm not in a dark place. I've got some obstacles in my way. I'll kick them down. I'm Drew McIntyre. I got it these days. But I didn't have it back then. I was just a kid. I had personal issues going on. I'd lost the person who was closest to me in the world. My career was in a tailspin, and I could have done with a real leader to tell me it was gonna be okay, to help me navigate this place, but you saw me as a threat, and that was never gonna happen. I've spoke to Randy Orton about this before, and I understand that Randy couldn't have helped me because he had his own demons. You're straight edge. You don't have any demons. You are a demon. A self-serving, narcissistic succubus. And I didn't need anybody to help me become a leader. Once I got fired, I figured it out. I stepped up myself, and I became the man I am today. So after being gone for 9 years, I'm your leader now, kid. All right, enough of the arse kissing, Jay. Don't you think that locker room is in enough state with you in it?
Adam Pearce, please hear me right now and trust me. Let him go. Nick Aldis, you can have him on SmackDown because trust me, we do not want CM Punk in that locker room. He will destroy this place from the inside out. I'm sorry, you actually know him? You know him personally? I'm one of the few people that traveled the world with him. I know what he's actually like, so I know how this story ends, but it's not about him, it's about you, Jay. Look at me. Seth Rollins, he deserved what he got. He made it personal. But Sami Zayn, you might actually have a point there. So, Sami, I want to talk to you. I know you're at home right now, and maybe I had a little to do with why you're at home right now. You did run your mouth a lot, and you did cross the line when you talked about my family. And to be fair to me, I did leave you with one good leg. But I'm sorry. You see that, Jay? That's called a freaking apology. That's how it's done. It's not perfect, but you're incapable of one when it comes to Drew McIntyre. You want to keep booing me like I'm wrong? No. I ain't wrong here. Let's do a little social experiment. Cleveland, imagine if you can, somebody hurt a family member of yours, hurt you. Your mom, your dad, your sister, your brother, your son, your daughter, they hurt them. Would you want revenge? Imagine they never apologized. By show of hands, and be honest, would you want to take revenge on them? Well, for a few of you, the truth will set you free. You didn't have your hand up, no? What's your name? Austin, get a shot of Austin. His family, he don't care about you, and he's a freaking coward. Sounds like people are a little upset about last week. You know who's most upset about the reaction to what I did last week? Me. I've been called a coward, a backstabber. I've heard, why, Drew, why? I have been the same person this entire time. I haven't lied one time. I didn't lie to Seth last week. I'm not lying right now. If you've been paying attention to the show, it's obvious to you. If you're a fan of Drew McIntyre, I don't have to explain myself. If you've turned on me, then that's on you. You were never a fan in the first place, and I don't give a damn what you think. I gave Jay something he never gave me when he attacked me from behind, time and time again. I looked him right in the eye before I dropped his arse. And Jay, you're probably looking for a sorry, an apology for costing you the tag titles, for costing you your big moment. I don't remember one apology to me or anyone else back there that you've screwed over with your family. I'm sure there was some collateral damage last week. No Cody was part of that match, but no, Cody did technically bring Jay to Raw, and I couldn't help but notice on SmackDown he attacked Jimmy and Solo, and people are probably telling him the same thing they tell me. Get over it. No. Why should we get over it? Huh? Why should I personally get over it? You know what Jay cost me? The biggest thing of all, Clash of the Castle, his bloodline, his family cost me the biggest moment of my life in front of my family.
Big D, Drew McIntyre, man, we didn't know you were cold-blooded like that, Drew. Because the Drew McIntyre that we know is not a coward like you showed us last week.
I mean, for real, for the past few years, We've been calling you Big D. But as of last week, it looks like there's been a little bit of shrinkage on your end. I mean, what's wrong, Drew? What's wrong? You scared? Or were you just worried that that big old sword you got was just a little too limp to get the job done?
Hey, Big D and Massive Miz were having a conversation.
Shut up, Miz. You just expect Drew McIntyre to save the day like always. I know you two were back there. Did you come out and do something? No. Multiple superstars did nothing. The one guy that came out, Cody, he wasn't doing it out of the goodness of his heart. It's his mess, Jay's here, and he's trying to clean it up. And what I seen tonight was the actions of a hypocrite.